subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Fit Study. In this video, we're going to see complete exam paper analysis and review of NEET 2020. And we are also going to see what is the difficulty level of the question paper, what is the difficulty level of different sections, what is student reaction on today's NEET 2020. All these things we're going to see in this particular video. So make sure you watch this video till the end. So now let's begin this video without any delay. First, let's see students' reaction. Most of the students told that biology is very easy compared to other sections. But the thing is, they told a paper is a bit lengthy. A few questions in biology is more time consuming compared to other questions. Okay, this is the first important review coming to biology. And students told physics is the toughest section compared to any other sections. Physics is really hard in the whole paper. And coming to chemistry, chemistry is moderate. 50 to 60% of the questions were very easy. 30 to 40% of the questions from chemistry are moderate. So the overall chemistry paper is moderate. Coming to the overall difficulty level of the NEET 2020 paper, few students told the paper was moderate and few students told paper was tough. We got mixed reactions from the students. Few students told they are expecting 600 plus and few students told the paper was tough. The most important point is all the questions from all the subjects came just from insert. See, if you prepare from insert, you can attempt 100% of the paper. Not even a single question came out of insert. The entire question paper is just from insert. Now let's see section wise analysis. First, let's see physics paper analysis. Coming to physics, topics came from mechanics, electrodynamics, optics and electronics. Most of the questions are conceptual based. What is meant by conceptual based? The questions are framed in a way, if you know the concept, you can easily answer those questions. Okay, few questions were entirely conceptual based and directly grabbed from concept, and few questions were tricky. Okay, they were logical. You need to spend at least more than a minute on those particular questions. And physics paper covered almost all the chapters, and the question paper is framed in a way it covered all the chapters and all the syllabus. 16 to 18 plus questions from physics were asked from class 11th, and 20 plus questions were asked completely from class 12. So the question paper was divided in a way where 16 to 18 plus questions were asked from class 11th and 20 plus questions were asked from class 12th. And few questions are simply formula based. If you know the formula, you are going to solve them. They are framed in such a way. Few questions involves lengthy calculations. It's taking 2+ minutes for a single question, because if students told that if they wanted to solve those questions, it's requiring lengthy calculations. Out of 45 questions in physics, 6 to 7 questions were tricky. Level of difficulty of 25 questions was in between moderate to difficult, and rest all questions were very easy. Most of the students found physics as one of the toughest section in the entire paper, but few students told physics paper is at the moderate level. Many candidates told they found difficult to solve the tricky questions and numerical questions. As I told you, physics paper is entirely from insert class 12 and class 11th. If you follow those books, you can easily attempt all the paper. And coming to physics, questions were asked from thermodynamics, optics, electromagnetic waves, current and electromagnetic induction. Now let's see chemistry section. Most of the students told questions from chemical reactions is tricky and they found them hard to solve. Out of 45 questions, 7 questions were difficult, 20 questions were medium and rest of the questions were very easy. And students told that most of the questions were directly asked from insert textbooks. Students who prepared really good from insert textbooks, they attempted almost all the questions for chemistry, and the questions are also asked from class 11th as well as class 12th. And coming to section wise and coming to physical, paper was a bit harder compared to last year. And coming to organic chemistry, few students told this part was moderate, few students told this part was very easy. And coming to chemistry, questions were asked from D block, coordination compound, chemical kinetics, feedlocks, polymers. In my previous videos, I told all these topics as important. So the students who watched those videos, I'm sure that they gave today's exam really well. And now let's see about biology section. Biology section is at most easy. And in biology, out of 90 questions, 45 questions were appeared from zoology and 45 questions came from botany. And out of total 90 questions, 30 plus questions were very easy, 45 plus questions were moderate, and rest of the questions were difficult. Overall, compared to any other sections, biology paper is really lengthy, and most of the students told they took so much time just to solve the biology paper. But biology is the easiest section out of all the sections, but it is a bit lengthy and time consuming. And there were direct questions, logical questions, as well as descriptive questions. Out of all the questions, descriptive questions were really time taking. Questions were asked from the direct concepts also. The students who studied concepts is really going to rock this exam, especially the biology section, because most of the questions were picked up from the concepts. And question paper is well balanced. It covered almost all the syllabus and all the topics which I told as important. And most of the questions were directly asked from insert. And coming to biology, questions were asked from principles of inheritance and variation, biological classification, sexual reproduction in flowering plants, molecular basis of inheritance, breathing and exchange of gases, environmental issues, etc., etc. All the topics which I gave as important section wise were asked in today's exam. So now let's see how many questions were asked from class 11th and class 12th section wise, and how much time it took in order to solve section wise. Coming to zoology, 16 plus questions were asked from class 11 and 20 plus questions were asked from class 12th topics. And in order to solve zoology paper, it's taking 20 minutes time approximately. Coming to botany, 25 plus questions were asked directly from class 11th topics, and rest of the questions were asked from class 12th topics. And even botany section took approximately 20 minutes to solve this paper. And coming to physics, 15 plus questions were asked directly from class 11th topics, and rest of the questions out of 45 were asked directly from class 12th topics. And it is taking around 75 to 80 minutes in order to solve entire physics section. And coming to chemistry, 20 plus questions were asked directly from class 11th topics, and rest of the questions were asked from class 12th topics, taking around 55 plus to 60 minutes in order to solve chemistry paper. So overall description of NEET 2020 analysis is physics paper is very tough compared to all the other sections. Biology paper is very easy, but the questions were asked directly from concepts and tricky questions were also asked. So it is a bit confusing and time consuming paper, and also it's a lengthy paper. Coming to chemistry, the difficulty level of chemistry is in between moderate to difficult. Few students told the paper was moderate and few students told paper was difficult. So, and almost all the questions, the entire paper were asked directly from the concepts. Coming to today's NEET 2020 paper, almost all the questions were asked directly from insert. The students who prepared insert really well can attempt almost all the paper, and the concepts were directly asked from class 11th and class 12th topics. Few concepts were asked from basics and concepts. If the students who are having the conceptual knowledge can answer all those questions, and students, NEET 2020 question paper along with answers video is coming up. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload NEET 2020 question paper answers and paper discussion video, you're going to get notified. So yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Like and share this video with all your friends, and thanks for watching.